Hi, my name's Corey, and I work at Agilent Technologies in the R&D lab. And customers have told us that when they're using our X-Series analyzers, they have difficulty setting up the gate when they're using very narrow pulses. So I'm here to show you a new feature that we've added to make it easier to set up the gate function with narrow pulses. I've got a PXA signal analyzer here and a PSG signal generator. So let's get started. So when you're making gated measurements, you want to set the gate start time, which is represented by the gate delay, to a number that's larger than this min fast value here. This blue line here with the label min fast shows you the time below which you do not want to set the gate delay. If you try to set the gate delay lower than that, you have to use a much lower sweep time to overcome transients in the system. So you really have to use min fast as the minimum value for your gate delay time. But in this case, we have set the gate start time to longer than min fast. And because the duty cycle of the pulse is about 50%, we have no trouble setting the gate length, represented by the gate stop value here, so that the gate start and the gate stop points fall well within the pulse. That's for a pulse like this, where we have about 50% duty cycle. This is a 50 microsecond pulse width. Now, if I change the pulse width to 5 microseconds, now you can see we're going to have difficulty setting the gate start and the gate stop times on that pulse so that we are pretty sure that the gate is only open when the pulse is high. Because the min fast time is here, we have to use this first pulse after min fast. And if we change the gate view sweep time so that we can see more of the pulse, it isn't very long before the pulse that we're trying to set the gate on just goes completely off the screen. To solve this problem, a new parameter called gate view start time has been added. The gate view start time is the time at the left side of the screen. So what we can do now is set the gate view start time to near what the min fast time is, and then we'll have plenty of range to set our gate view sweep time. If I turn on a marker and I move the marker to the min fast line, I can see that min fast is at about 328 microseconds. So let's set the gate view start time to be about 320 microseconds. When we do that, now I can make the gate view sweep time smaller and smaller. In fact, let's move it down to about 75 microseconds. And now you can see, here's the min fast line, here's the first pulse after min fast. And again, I'm not going to have any trouble setting the gate delay and the gate length so that they're nicely on the pulse, so that when I turn on the gate, I get a solid line at the top of the screen, which is what you want. So that's how gate view start time makes it easier to make measurements on narrow pulses in the PXA signal analyzer. The PXA is the industry's highest performance signal analyzer, but this feature is also available on other members of the X series. For more information, visit our website at this URL. Thanks for watching.